Hey guys, a bit distracted this morning actually in my trading, so I decided to just stop and talk about exactly what. So I decided to go with the Tyga high melt exhaust, and I have a little bit of buyer's remorse, just a little bit, and I'll tell you why. And I should have just, maybe it's not that big of a deal. It could just be me being just a little antsy. Oops. But anyway, let's talk about why I decided to go with the Tyga. The Tyga, I bought it shipped like $485. So this is the dyno of the Yoshi and also of the Tyga with a basically with the dyno results against you. I think this one is without a tuned ECU, and this one I don't know if they use a tuned ECU or not. Let's just assume that it is not a tuned ECU. If it is a tuned ECU, then this is definitely much better. But okay, so let's talk about it. So so why did I go with so my buyer's remorse is like two things. One, I actually like the low mount look better than the high mount. And two, like supposedly the Tyga, this is my bad, the Tyga is actually pretty loud. And while I do like, you know, to hear my bike a little bit more, it might be a little bit too loud, so I might have to buy an additional baffle or a silencer for the exhaust, which could affect performance. But let's just talk about the performance and what I see. So talking to, just chatting with East Coldish, and he said the results are probably going to be similar, and I think he's right about this. So let's talk about, it's hard to see because, you know, obviously, let's talk about where to peak. So at 7,000 RPM, which, you know, it's not too bad. It's I usually cruise at around 6,000 RPMs. So, let's see. So let's take a look. Let's take a closer look at that. At 6,000 RPM, the red line is the base. They're about the same. Unfortunately, they're about the same. But once it gets to the 7,000 RPM, that's about 9 point, just shy of 10. And we take a look at the So it's hard to read this graph, but I believe this is 7 right here. A 7. See, yeah, this is probably why I should have gone. It looks like, no, the red line is the base. So it's just a little bit at 6,000 RPMs. Actually, there's a huge difference between 6,000. So at 6,000 RPM is making around 8. And so actually, I don't think this is apples to apples comparison. So let's take a 6,000 RPM. No, that's about right. It's making about 8. So it's really just kind of at the higher RPMs, it's this exhaust is where it really shines. So yeah, so I probably should have gone with the Yoshi, even though, actually, to be honest, it wasn't really that much more expensive. But let's say at 7,000 RPM, it's just shy of 10. And it, at 8,000 RPM, it's about 9.5. Let's see where this one's at. At 8,000 RPM, so this is 8, so this would be 9. So that's 9 right there. Yeah, it's a little bit less. It's at 9,000 RPM, it's just sitting at 9. But you can see, at 9,000 RPM, which is right here, and again, it's just sitting at 9 as well. So,
take a couple cents.
And I don't know if this is tuned too. This does look like it's possibly tuned. I know the yes screen on there. So yeah, I might have should have probably just spent the extra money just to get the Yoshi and not the Tyga. Unfortunately, I don't think I can return the Tyga. That's the problem. So I'm kind of stuck with it. And yeah, maybe. I mean, that's not the smartest decision I've made. I don't think that there is not a huge difference, like when you talk about horse power. So, one of the problems, this is really weird because, like, let's say at 9,000 RPM, this one is sitting at, it feels like this. There's more mods on that one than this one. But at 9,000 RPM, this one is sitting at 7. Right, stock, and this one at 9,000 RPM, it's sitting well above 7. So there must be something else going on here. So it's hard to. And also, once I get the tuned ECU, this should be well over 10. So I'm just wondering if this is. I need to look at his video a little bit more, see if the ECU is actually tuned or not. But yeah, let's think about this a little bit more. So it's also let's take a look at 4,000 RPM, 5,000 RPM. At 5,000 RPM, this thing is making like 7.2 over. 6.6 or something, and here 5,000 RPM. Oh, also this one, this one is making around 7. This is like over 7, a little under 7. So I okay. The other thing is that this cuts off. This starts off at 4. And okay, let's just take a look. So it looks like maybe I just need to buy a baffle for it. This is not that big of a deal. But the only other thing is that Yoshi has titanium. It had that really nice look to it, which I kind of like too. Okay, I'm not that. I'm pretty stupid. Okay, I also made a gun. Okay, so at 4,000 RPM, this is like what, 5.5? Stock is at like 5. Alright. So, at 4,000 RPM. Yeah, this doesn't make sense. It can't obviously be less than that. So they, okay, so I guess really that's not realistic because I don't think the dyno did that correct. Let's say 5,000 RPM again. 5,000, I guess at 5,000 RPM they're pretty similar. Maybe 7.5? And this one is like what, 6.8? Sorry, there's also something playing in the background. So this one's hard to tell, but I believe 7's right there.
I usually tell myself to try and float to one stop button.
So 7. A little over 7. So it looks like the Yoshi is a little bit more powerful overall. But let's look at 8,000 RPM again. Hmm.
I took the third dip. It's my rule to not take the third dip.
Yeah, look, definitely buyer's remorse at this point. I should have researched this a little bit more. Because the difference between two is like 180. And I think that 180 is definitely worth having the Yoshi. So at 8, we're like at what? Probably a little bit above 9. At 8. Yeah, we're like well into like in the mid like 9s. Is this really? I guess it's also against the base too, right? Because there's different. Okay, like I'm a. It's not gonna see this, but I'm gonna put a line. I'm gonna put a thing against it real quick. I'm gonna get a. Okay, one second. I'm gonna get a piece of. I'm getting a straight edge and comparing it against two. It's 8,000 RPM. I guess that's really where. Okay, so 8 is right there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, they're actually about the same. I would say the Yoshi is just a little bit better again, but you also have to compare this against the baseline too, right? So, all right, let's just see. Sorry, how long is this video going? I'm just mumbling on about why I have buyer's remorse. It's already 12 minutes. Okay, so let's just do this mathematic. So it says max RPM is around 7.3. Okay. Max horsepower, I'm sorry. 7.3, so that's like right there, right? So, okay, also let me do this. Why am I doing this? I'm so stupid. Let's do this. This thing is 24K. Okay, now that's a lot better. Okay, 7.3. Okay, so its max RPM is probably at 7. Okay, so it's 1.2 horsepower difference at the max RPM, or the max horsepower. Wow, this is an HD and still. Really, it's right there? That's probably looks like more like there. So, let's just say that's like 9.8. And base is like. Like what? What is base there? So 9.8. So 1.3. So versus 1.2. So that's. So I think I definitely need to buy a silencer. Do I buy the silencer? I'll just buy a cheap silencer online on eBay and see how that one goes. still want to see Landau's like about here. Because really, if you think about it, if you want to, at 9,000 RPM, that's really kind of, I'm trying to think exactly where I'm going. Okay, not 9,000, like 8.5 RPM, that's really kind of like, really for me, for revving it out. Let's see what the difference is, like right there. So, that. So that's about,
I guess
it actually gets really wide right there, right? Which is good, right? Let's check the look. Again, this is extremely just anecdotal. 8.5 is right about there. That's a little bit above 8. And a little bit above 9. So like 1.1 right there. This one is actually underneath 8 compared to his, this one, which is at 8, right? It's a little bit above 8. So I guess the baseline is different, right? Compared to the two. Maybe they also dynoed it differently. So yeah, I guess it's more of a percentage. Like, let's say this is, and this really falls off. Yeah, okay. So, I'm gonna wrap this video up. So here are the two. It's not apples to apples comparison, unfortunately. Probably should still have gone with the Yoshi, because now I have to buy a silencer. I do like sound, but now I think about it, I do have these perpetual headaches. That really doesn't help. So, yeah, I probably should have got the Yoshi. And for a number of reasons, because I like the low muffler. Also, because the muffler is lower, actually it doesn't really matter. I like the low muffler look, and there's also the titanium. This is not titanium. And I think the Yoshi comes with a baffle too, so in case you want to put a silence it a little bit more.
It is a little tricky. You can't forget this.
What else can we say? Yeah. It's probably just worth it to just get the. At 9,000 RPM. I don't think I ever get up to 9,000 RPM.
Incron is about to come.
Well, maybe I do, but do I really? I mean, if you compare this with this, there's huge differences, right? Actually, I'm probably more like right here at the moment because I do have the PST cover. Wow, there's a 1 horsepower difference with the TST cover. Right? This is 7. And then this is like 8. Right? And then this is like at almost 9. So I guess this is really where it's really important, right? If you think about it a little bit more. So this thing 1.2, I think this is 1.2 at max horsepower, which is probably here at 7,000 RPM. Which is, important, but if you want to go faster, I think this is where it's actually really important, right? At 9,000, between 8.5 and 9,000 RPM. Right, this is more than 1.2, it's probably closer to 1.5, 1.7, right? Maybe even here. Like, if that is 7, right? And this is 9, right there. Right, just shy of 9. Then that's a 2 horsepower difference. That's a 25% difference in horsepower. Which...
start off about 15 and then from there on.
Which is important, right? So let's take a look at this one too. So at 9, 8.5, like we're right there. Oh, there's more granularity here. Between 8.5 here. Well, this is at like what?
Might dip down lower.
Above. Yeah, this. There must be something else being done. Okay, there must be an air box on this one, right? On the red, on the base. So the difference, let's take a look at the absolute value. So it's a, okay, it's above 9, so it's like 9.2. And this is like 9.2. Yeah, 9.2. The scale's interesting. 9.2. And this one's at 7.6. So 7.6 to 9.2. So that's like 1.5, 1.6. So yeah, I guess to be honest, like if maybe what I'm doing now is just an apples to apples, not a really apples to apples comparison, just me being a little bit bias remorse. So yeah, and then also this is without a tuned exhaust. This was probably tuned ECU. This is without a flasher tuned ECU. This might be with something, I don't know. Anyway, it'll be here Monday. I'll probably install it right away. I won't have the tuned ECU right away because I need to send it in. So I'll probably ride it with just a reset ECU. I'll be a week, so I'll get it Monday next week. So I'll get it like Monday next week. So I'll probably six. So I'll probably have like an entire week about basically about the bike, about the tunes, because I'll get it Monday. I'll probably just ride it around just a little bit, and then I'll send out the ECU on Tuesday. Then I'll probably get the ECU back on 14th. So yeah. And I'm definitely gonna buy, I should definitely buy a baffle because I need to figure out which baffle to buy. Let me buy it now before it comes. So that I can figure out what to do. Alright, sorry for the long video, guys. Overall, I think I should have probably gone with the Yoshi. There does not seem to be that big of a difference from a percentage standpoint. These two are not apples to apples comparisons. But I think from a percentage standpoint, they're pretty similar. I'm hoping with the tuned ECU that I get well above like 10, so somewhere between 10 and 11. I'm hoping the tuned ECU gives me another half a horsepower to 0.75 or